Early November, 8 members of the Gantouw Hiking Club did a 4-day hike to Towerkop Mountain in the Kleinswartberg near Ladismith. At 2,189 m, Towerkop is the third highest peak in the Western Cape. Arriving at the farm from where our hike starts, one of our vehicles got stuck in the soft sand after the recent rain. Unable to free ourselves, we called for help, and the friendly farmer sent a tractor to get us out. After lunch on day one, we started the 3 to 4 hour hike of 6 km to the shepherd's shelter, where we overnight. The Gantouw Hiking Club was founded in 1977, and since then has offered weekly day hikes in the Boland, Overberg and Cape Peninsula. The club has a membership of over 120 hikers spanning various age groups. It's more than just a club, it's a community united by a shared love for the great outdoors.
What's that?
It's very far. So it's just around the corner.
As we start this adventure, we were a diverse group of 8 individuals, aged 53 to 76, brought together by a common goal. Strangers, really. But by the end of the day's hike, the exchange of stories, the laughter, and the shared struggles made it feel like we had known each other for a lifetime. We underestimated the water requirements for this climb, assuming there would be multiple streams after the recent rains. As a result, most of us ran out of water and ended up getting dehydrated, reaching the shelter fatigued. We arrive at the shelter where we overnight. The shelter can also serve as a base camp from where one climbs the peak as a day outing.
Ons het water.
Did you run out of water?
Yeah. So I just filled up with some water and got some rehydrating.
Gerrit, jy het water uit gehardloop.
Ja, ek het weer 'n bietjie water geskep daaronder. Maar ek het asem ook uit gehardloop. Lang laat so moeg.
Wat is hier vir aandete?
Ek dink ek
soek al weg nou net sy water omgegooi. Diep strakker nog. Gerrit, ek wil net jou aandete kom inspecteer.
Maar is verby nou.
Oh.
Raaikou en klare. En
was het lekker?
Ja, heerlijk, met baltong ingemeng en alles.
After a windy night at the shelter, we woke up to perfect weather. Following an early morning breakfast, we set off for a strenuous section of rock stepping, which takes us through the Golden Gate, followed by another steep stretch, eventually leading to the Nell's Cave Terrace and the cave where we planned to overnight. When climbing a mountain, there is something mystical about putting one foot in front of the other. The mountain liberates one from life's competitiveness. In society, people compete for the best positions and to be first. But on a hiking trip, everyone is equal and helps each other climb the mountain together, whether you are 53 or 76. In society, the best and strongest often come out on top. But on a hiking trip, we celebrate when everyone reaches the summit together. In society, success is synonymous with money and possessions. But on a hiking trip, a 60-rand inflatable mattress from Crazy Store sleeps just as comfortable as a 2,000-rand mattress from a well-known brand.
I've been lost and led by a star. Tonight I'm seeing nothing but dark. Pull all the lights together. so raw. Scared to show the things we all want, helped by all the sparks that had gone. Suddenly the coldest.
Who was that?
But we're all chasing gold. We won't find it alone. And now I know what love is. I can't believe we lost.
After dinner, course. Now I know what love is.
Amazing look. First impressions. Glad I'm here. But it's worth it. These blows close beneath the skin. Now we both close.
Due to water dripping from the roof of the cave, only Garrett chose to sleep inside. The others opted for a night's rest on a grass slope below the cave and underneath large rocks on the cliff's edge, enjoying the boundless views.
John, what's happening here?
Reading. The joys of Kindle. Yeah, is your bed made?
What is this, a room with a view?
Absolutely the best roof view ever, eh? I think it's a terrace apartment.
Is baie mooi. Is baie mooi. Ek dink jammer ek gaan nie die sonsopkom sien nie.
As the day bid farewell, we were treated to the most stunning sunset, painting the sky gold, orange and pink.
Now I know what love is. I can't believe we lost. Shadow on the surface fades into the moon. Now I know what love is. I can't believe we lost. Maybe I'm still searching.
God.
Môre, gaan ek met die ysbeertjies.
Moet jy geslaap?
Koud.
Lekker.
Koud.
Opstaan tyd.
Ja, the sun is out, but it's so cold. It's freezing out, you know. Just stay where you are because it's so cold.
Doing my coffee, yeah, I think.
You doing coffee in there?
Yeah.
Diane, hoe jy geslaap?
Verskriklik sleg. Jy kan nie dink hoe koud dit was nie.
En ek weet dit is.
Is erger as by julle.
My
wind kom van hier net by daai voordeur in, sien jy?
Ja.
On day 3, we did a relaxed exploration of the western and eastern pinnacle of Towerkop. To appreciate the sheer magnitude of the towering Towerkop peak up close, one need to scramble up a steep gradient of loose scree, commonly referred to as the escalator. For every 2 steps up, you slide one down. This ascent proves somewhat tiring, but offers a uniquely peculiar experience.
Who's that?
Shui!
Lekker man.
I think it's all grip. That's it.
Okay.
The peak was deemed unclimbable, and a bet of £50 was made in Ladismith that nobody could get to the top. Then, in 1885, a young farmer named Gustav Neft made history in being the first person to climb Towerkop. And probably unknown to him at the time, he also opened the first rock climbing route in South Africa.
Gustav Neff, die eerste ascent van Towerkop was in 1889 en is daar in daai gully op is hy op tot heel bo en met die terugkom het hy die laaste stukkie net laat los en geval een paar meter. En toe het hy sy 50 pond gaan klim, maar hulle wou het nie gee nie, want niemand het hom geglo nie. Toe het hy later vir hulle gaan bewys, want hy het sy een sokkie daar bo gelos onder 'n klip.
Right there at the top, that man's got a nose sticking out.
Yeah.
Look at that. Amazing.
Legend has it that Towerkop, meaning magic peak, got its name after a witch was trying to fly home one evening, but the mountain kept looming higher in front of her. Out of frustration and anger, she smacked it with her broomstick, and it split into two.
Towerkop, yes, like you've never seen it before.
The best.
For the best view of Towerkop, we climbed the adjacent Towerkop. From here, we also enjoyed spectacular views of both Glane and Groot Coulee.
Fantastic. Top of the world.
Which way do we go?
Way down, the hikers shared their thoughts and experiences from the climb. Henry says it was tough but beautiful. An epic trip. One that will go into the memory banks. Rhea says Towerkop was an unforgettable hike. I've never climbed over such boulders before. Had the most beautiful sleeping spot ever. John says it was amazing. I enjoyed the experience with awesome people. Pat says it was a fantastic adventure. So enjoyable. Garrett grew up in Ladismith. His lifelong wish came true when he stood on Towerkop with a clear view towards Towerkop. He saw the proverbial promised land. Chris says it's won his list of the top 5 mountain experiences in the Western Cape. Tomorrow I will miss backing my bag, putting one foot in front of the other. How blessed we were with a variety of weather experiences. Heat, cold, mist, wind. Luckily no rain.